Hi, this is Chrisferb, and I'm going to review how to set up a parent-child database relation between two tables. It's going to be a short example, although it takes a little bit of time to set it up. So, right off the bat, a parent-child relationship is really common. You don't always see it. Take, for instance, you go to Amazon or a big store, Best Buy Online or something like that. You set up an account, and then you purchase something. And so, each time you go back, you're using the same account that's just the parent record. Your customer account, and then all of your items that you buy are attached to that account. So that's kind of what a parent-child relationship is. The other thing is we can't have purchases in the example I was just talking about without having the parent record, which is the customer. So you can't buy things at Best Buy Online without having a customer account linked to it, which makes sense. That's why this setup that I'm going to do is pretty practical. Okay. So starting off, we're going to create a database, and we're going to create it in design mode. You can actually create it just by typing. I don't recommend that at all because it's not kind of a clean way to do it. Okay, so we are in the design mode here. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create an ID field, and we're going to call it customer ID, and it's going to be auto number. We always want auto number for our ID fields, unless we have a reason not to do it. But as a default, it's not bad. This is also going to be our key. That means there can't be duplicates, and it's usually searchable, it's indexed. I'm going to save this table, and we're going to call it tblCustomers. So it's descriptive. And I have tbl, so I know when I look at it that it's a table right off the bat. It's obvious right here, but it's not always obvious in other places. And it's also kind of good database practice. Okay, now we can add some fields to this. So we're going to do fname for first name. And then short text, it's going to be, I believe, 25 characters. So short text, 25 characters. We don't want it to be 255, and that's because it wastes space. Now, in reality, we can do a couple different things here. We can do required, allow zero length, no. So say we'd make it required, not allow zero length, which would be no, and that would make it so you have to put something in. So I'm just leaving that blank for now because I have a couple things to talk about in this video, and it'll take some time. Next thing, lname. And it's going to be short text, and it's going to be, I think, 35. We usually want to do last names longer, just because people have sometimes longer last names. And then phone. And for our phone, you would think, oh, well, we would pick numbers, but that's not necessarily the case. Unless we're doing pure math, we sometimes want numbers as text because we can format it much easier than using numbers. So we're going to, We're going to do short text, but we're going to do an input mask. And an input mask, over here on these ellipses, once we click in the input mask, we have the little ellipses button. And, oh, we need to save it first. It is saved, I thought. Okay, so we're going to do phone number. And then we're going to accept the defaults for the input mask. And the input mask makes it so when we type things in, it's not letting me put letters in, but we have to put numbers in, see. So the input mask is a good thing. And it makes us type everything out. Missed one. So that's what the input mask does. It makes us put in proper input. Next. And we're not going to store the symbols. That means the parentheses. So we just want the numbers. It's cleaner in database world. Database theory, it's typically better. Finish. Okay. So we have short text. Oh, and we want it to be about 10. The size to be about 10. And save everything. Okay. I think we should be okay there. Okay. While we're here, let's put a couple customers in. Okay, let's see. Joe. Smith. And the phone number, I don't really care which one you put in, but it looks okay. And the next one's going to be Jane. Oh, I need to hit tab. Jane. And when you hit tab, you go to the next field. Now, typically, once you get this all set up, you could just use the input form, but we're kind of doing it manually so that you can see how everything relates together and then put in some numbers. So what you're seeing with the customer ID is that's going to be our primary key in this table is going to be a foreign key in the next table. So I'm putting in three people. We don't need a lot for this example. Oh, my fingers are cold. Okay. And then some numbers. Okay. So we put in some data, and once we move on, it's storing the data, so technically you don't need to save it or anything like that. I'm gonna close it, and that data is in the table. You can tell by going back and seeing it. Okay, so we close that, and now we're going to go and create another table, and we're gonna use design. Now, if you do the design, you have to specify the primary key specifically. If you added the table by typing in, it creates an ID for you and does all that. But there's a lot of drawbacks to creating the table by typing the data. It doesn't make sense, in my opinion. But it's an option. Okay, our table name, let's put a field in it and then we can save it. So our table name is, the table's gonna be TBL cars, but the first car ID for this is gonna be car ID. And it's gonna be auto number is gonna be our key. And we're gonna make it the primary key. Key field primary key. That's what I meant. And it's gonna be TBL cars. Okay, so this is gonna be the table that holds all the cars that are related to the customer. It's gonna be okay. So, yep, it's saved. Okay, we move on to the next one. And so that's gonna be the key, let's see. So the next one's gonna be car, customer ID. And then, now this is gonna be it's going to be a number that comes from our customer table, and we're in the car table. This is how the tables are gonna be linked. So it needs to be a number, and it's going to be a long integer, which is the default. And that's gonna match up with our auto number. So that's fine. Okay, the next one is the make. I'm putting a couple fields so we can kind of see how it works. And it's gonna be short text, which is good, but we don't want 255 for the character length. It's gonna be 20. And like I said before, if it was a real database, production database, we'd have all kinds of rules because we don't wanna allow junk in our database. We wanna filter it out. Okay, let's see, make is in there, that's good. And the last one, description. Fingers are cold, so they're hard to type. Okay, short text. Now, it's actually gonna be long text, which used to be called a memo field in Access. And also known as comment field or long text for different databases. But there's always some way to put in a lot of text or paragraphs, and this is it for long text. Okay, let's save it. So I think we're good. We're gonna add some cars. Okay, car customer. Now, I'm adding in some records that I know. Now, for this one, I'm gonna add in, take for instance, we're gonna say car customer ID 3. Like I said, normally you can do this in the front end, but number 3, car customer number 3, is actually the ID of one of our customers. So we have 3, and then it's gonna be make, and then say oil changed at 34,000. Miles. Okay, let's put in one more. And for this one, It's going to be customer, what is that, customer 2. And the make is going to be GM. And then let's say tires. At say 45,000 miles. Okay, and then let's just do another one. We're gonna say it is still customer number 2, and he also has bought a Toyota from this company. Toyota, and no comments, and that's fine. Okay. Now, like I said, as you move on, it's saving the data, so you don't actually have to save it. I can just close this and go back. That's what databases do. They save it as you go. It's a huge difference between working with Word or Access, Excel, any of those. Okay, so now we have these two tables, and they're not connected. Technically, we could do what we just did. We can add a car and say that a customer bought it and not even have the customer doesn't even need to exist. So we need to fix that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into database tools, and we're going to go into relationships, and we're going to add both tables that we want. So that one, and close. Okay, so we have these two little table looking squares here. And they usually, on the top, it says what the table name is, and then down the side, and you can see that the primary key has a little key by it, which is nice. Okay, so, and we're also, our tables are closed. Otherwise, you'd see the tabs of the tables up here, and we wouldn't be able to do any relationships if they weren't closed. So, what we want to do is we want to go from the, let's rearrange this. We want to go from the customers to the cars, and we're going to link customer ID to car customer ID, and we can just click on it and drag it, and then it opens up the edit relationship menu. So we take a look at it, and we see, you know, this looks like what we want. We want to click enforce referential integrity. If we don't select that, then there's no purpose in why we're relating things, the tables. So we click enforce referential integrity. Cascade, now we have some options. Cascade, update record, update related fields. Cascade, delete related records. Now for this, I'm not checking these, but in the real world, it's possible if you wanted to delete a customer, you could delete all of his purchases. There's lots of implications behind that, which I won't get into. But for now, we just want to make sure things match. That's enforce referential integrity. We don't want to have purchases of cars without customers. So we do create. And if it goes right, you're not going to get any funny errors, which we did not get. I'm going to move these. You can see that it says 1 to the infinity sign, which means many. So it's a 1-to-many relationship. Now, when we go into cars, or actually let's go into customers, we see that we have Joe Smith, and if I click on this little plus, which means there's more connected here, well, see, there's no records, but this shows the relationship. But Jane has two records. Jane Johnson has two cars connected. And I don't think Mike has any. Oh, he has the 4. Yes. Okay. So this is okay, but it's not quite as useful as maybe we want. You can see we could add a record right here, but it's not the most useful yet. So I'm going to close these, and I'm going to close the relationships. It's going to ask us to save. We want to click yes. So the last thing that we want to do to make this really useful is we want to create a form, which will help us view the data and search the data and add data, add and delete. So I always use the form wizard because it works pretty well. Forms are not always the easiest to work with, or reports. I recommend you use the form wizard or report wizard, and then you go back and make the changes in the actual design sections. Okay, form wizard. And in this case, we're going to add all of our, let's see, we're in customers. Let's add all of our customer information. Or we could have just hit the little double arrows. And then for cars, we can add all of the car information as well, just so we can take a look at that. And next, okay. Now, this is picked up that they're linked. So it says, how do you want to view your data? So if we want to view it by cars, that's probably not the right answer, right? But by customers, we see customer up here, and then it's going to link all the cars. So this is a parent-child type of form. So we want that. Tabular or data sheet, not a big difference here, is it? Not sure which one we had first. Let's do tabular. And then finish. Okay, we have a parent-child form. So as I click forward down here to the next record, I can see the cards that have been purchased. And I see that this Mike Ferbichet had one. Jane Johnson had two. And Joe Smith did not have any. Now, we can add a record in here. So we can always go and start typing data in. Or we can add a record for the customer. And we can go from there. So this is the quick rundown on how this works. Now, this isn't ideal because it's actually, there's kind of not a lot of space here to look at. So one thing we could do real quick while we're here is we can change our view and go into, let's see, layout view. Yeah, just change it a little bit. Let's see if this stays. Save it, and then okay. So we can manipulate it. One of the views, design view, has a lot of things you can do to it. It's more into the programming domain, but not actually programming. But there's a lot of things you can do, change labels and all kinds of things. You might, if you're going to use this every day, you might change this from the label on here. Say it says Fname to first name, of course. So that's it for now. That is how you set up a parent-child database relationship and tables in Microsoft Access. I hope that was informative.